A few days ago, I took a picture of Uranus, Georgemsidus. Before I get into the pronunciation of the name of the planet, let me show you the amazing picture I took of the ice giant with my telescope. Behold, the not a dot. This is the first time I've imaged a planet where it wasn't just a few pixels of light. Unlike Mars, Jupiter, or Saturn, it's really difficult to see or take a picture of this planet. At a distance of more than 1.7 billion miles, it's almost twice as far as Saturn. Even though technically, according to some people with really, really good vision, in really, really dark skies, Uranus can be seen with the naked eye, it's still very, very, very difficult. I've never seen it with my naked eyes, and I've never worn glasses, and I have perfect vision. Uranus or Gregory Sinus? Georgemsidus. Best way to find the planet with your telescope is by star hopping. You can use an app like Stellarium to help you find it. And for someone like me living in Borel 8 skies, I needed help finding the planet. So I recruited the help of Astroberry running ECOS to place solve my way into finding the 7th planet. And this is what my setup looked like. My telescope was the Nexstar 6 SE on my CEM 40 mount, and my camera was the ASI 533 MC Pro, and the laptop was running Fire Capture. I also had Astroberry running on my Raspberry Pi to help me place solve, find, and center the planet. I also took images using a 3x Barlow, which made my telescope's effective focal length to be 4500 millimeters. But at that narrow field of view, the atmosphere played a huge role in making it much more difficult to see and focus on the planet. And since it was my first time trying to take an image of the planet using this setup, I ended up overexposing Uranus. I took all those frames that I captured and I stacked them in auto-stacker and tried my best to process them in astrosurface. I've learned a lot and I'm ready for next time. I also wish I had a bigger telescope so that I can get closer to and take a higher resolution picture of Uranus. If you're still here, thank you. Let me tell you about the name of the planet and how to pronounce it. This planet was the first planet ever discovered, and it was discovered by William Herschel on March 13, 1781. The name Uranus didn't become official everywhere until 1850, so what did William Herschel name it originally? British astronomer Neville Maskelyne asked Herschel to name the planet after himself. And in response, Herschel named the planet Georgemsidus, which meant George's Star in honor of King George III of England. You'd think that a big brown noser like that wouldn't have objected to naming the planet Uranus. In 1782, Johann Bode proposed the name Uranus, pronounced Uranus, after the Greek god of the sky. The German dude didn't know how the spelling would affect the English-speaking world. But William Herschel didn't budge, even after chemist Martin Klaproth named his newly discovered element uranium after the name for the new planet. The name Uranus was most widely used until 1850 when it was made official everywhere. And today, whether you pronounce the name Uranus, Uranus, or Uranus, you are correct. If you prefer the name Georgemsidus, you may be possessed by the ghost of William Herschel and you should have that checked. Let me know how you pronounce the name of the 7th planet in the solar system in the comments below. I'm curious. Curious?